In this next video, the schematic diagrams and the panel layout are covered. Let's take a quick look. The control panel is 21 inches wide by 27 inches tall, and typically it would be housed in a 24 inch wide by 30 inch tall enclosure. For our demonstration, we have not placed it in an enclosure to make it more easily to view. All of the various control components that make up our control system, such as the Do-more PLC, SureStep drive and power supply, power line filter, relays, DC power supply, signal conditioner, and Ethernet hub are secured to the panel, either with the use of 35 millimeter DIN rail or directly mounted with fasteners. Also located on the control panel are the terminal blocks, fuse holders, DIN rail, wire duct, and to make wiring quicker, the use of ZipLink pre-wired connection cables and modules. An easy choice. A complete bill of materials has been created and is available as a downloadable takeaway PDF file under the Videos Related Documents category. Sheet 1 of the schematic diagram shows the wiring for the incoming power through the transient surge protector to the master control circuit. It shows the power wiring through the various circuit protector fuses to the PLC, DC power supply, receptacle outlet, C-more, and the stepper system power supply. Sheet 2 includes wiring for the 4 to 20 milliamp analog input module that is used for the laser distance sensor that detects that a part has been loaded. The ZipLink cable and connector wiring is also shown. The pin numbers for the multi-wire connectors and the multi-conductor cable are also shown. Sheet 3 includes the Do-more 16-point and first 8-point DC input modules. The absolute encoder is wired into the 16-point input module, and the various proximity sensors are wired into the shown 8-point input module. Both modules make use of ZipLink connectors and cables. Sheet 4 shows the second 8-point DC input module. It is used primarily as the input for the color sensor's 3-bit output that decodes the color detected. The three signals are interfaced from the color sensor through a signal conditioner to the DC inputs. The module is used also for a few other signals. One signal is the air output from the laser distance sensor that could be used in our system as an operator alarm if desired. The other additional signal is the SureStep advanced drive output that indicates the stepper motor is moving. Sheet 5 shows the PLC's 8-point DC output module. It is used to control the two solenoid valves that operate the steel and brass ball reject slide cylinders. It also provides a signal from the ladder logic through an optical isolator that triggers the color sensor to take a reading. There is one additional DC output that is used that could be used, if needed, to disable the laser distance sensor's emitted light output. The last schematic, Sheet 6, covers the SureStep advanced drive and stepper motor wiring. It also includes details for the serial communications cable that is routed between the serial port on the Do-more CPU and the SureStep drive. Shown here is the scaled drawing of the control panel. All of the components were laid out and located to allow for the easiest wiring between the different components. Look for the other videos in this series. Thank you for watching.